Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You want to be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You want to be where everybody knows your name.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the show. I apologize. My fault. I work hard. I work hard for a living. Things need getting done and time gets away from me. And then we're going to be premiering a trailer here. And sometimes when other people play trailers, echoes happen. I didn't want any of that. So, but it's all sorted now. It's done. We've got it. We got it going. Welcome, everybody. The chat's been going great. The Bergen Discord, I've been reading it as much as I can. I see you guys have questions in there. I see you're making fun of me. I see you're calling me late and gay. Late is hate. I saw Leroy saying he was, you know, he's really happy that there's no other big CG show out there that happens to stream at this time on a Thursday. It's good. Good that doesn't happen, so that we get all you lovely people in here. Speaking of you lovely people, let's say hello to you. Let's do what we do. We got Rick Sauer in the house, Jason Black, Lama Gigante, Amit Rayner's here, Dojo Kun Comics, Dario's here, Hockey. Hockey says lag. Why would he say that? NTM Comics is here. Sci-fi for me. Hey, we haven't seen sci-fi for me in a while. Great to have you back. Skip Edwards is here. He says, hail the chat. Greg is here. Hail, Bogans. Billy Basco. Hello, Billy. Amanda B. Will we need to turn the volume down for trailers? Make sure to warn us. Yeah. Well, look, here's what I want to do tonight. I want you guys to throw me suggestions, and maybe you wonderful wrenchers can post links. I was just thinking of, like, you know, doing what we did before, where we ask you guys, well, we ask the chat what you guys think about it. Because I'm sure you're the ones who know, you know, whether a trailer turns you on or not. Hello, Jimmy. Give me the big Michael. I borrow ideas. Felix Hass is here. Great to see Felix, as always. Who else? Jim Cox. Hello, Jim. Hello, Leroy. I don't know what to say. Manny Conejo. Hello, Manny. Hello, everyone. Yeah, welcome, Manny. I don't think we've met before. Great to have you here in the chat. Who else? Scrolling down. A lot of people commenting. Great to see. Wow, Bancroft is gayer than Boy George. I don't know. You'd have to ask Mel about that. At least Bancroft has an excuse for being late this time. Technically still watching Liam's stream. No, I stopped that a good 5 minutes in, 5 minutes before, sorry. So it wasn't because of that. We got K Manifesto here. Who else? Bancroft sleep behind the wheel again. Yeah, it happens. Here's the raid coming over from Liam's Unintelligent Design channel. Thank you so much, Liam, for sending people over here. We got Raid from Zero Depressive. William C, let the gayness begin. Sam Spade in the house. There's Bros here. Hello, Bros. Did I say hello to Dean? I don't remember if I did. Hello, Dean. William Palmieri. Sorry if I mispronounce your name there, mate. Virgil's here. So many lovely faces today. Great to see. Always great to see. But I think that's it. So it is time to bring on our lovely guest. First time on the show. Terry Dactyl asks, is this a good show? Don't ask Mo. Don't ask Leroy. Don't never ask I Borrow Ideas. I think Vanessa might be truthful. Definitely ask Rick Sailor. Rick Sailor will give you the truth. Oh, and we got Don 40 here as well. Let's bring on our guest. We've never had Joe on the show before, but I have hung out with him a little bit over on How to Draw Comics. He's got a fantastic looking book coming out, and let's just get it done. Hello, Joe.
What's up? Glad I'm here.
Oh man, good. You know, you survived a 5-minute intro. Sometimes they go longer, sometimes they go shorter. But there we go, Rick Saylor. Sexiest show on CG. How are we talking trailers without talking about Zach? Zach, as in your boy Zach? See, I mean, he's kind of renowned to have the worst trailers out of all. I think we're talking about what makes a great campaign trailer, not necessarily just chatting about whatever comes into your mind for about 16 minutes, although it seems to work. Yeah. Have you ever seen a Zach trailer, Joe?
I believe I have. What's the first one that everyone goes to that was bad? That's the one.
Sitting in front of a wire, like a wire fence on his balcony, looking out into nothing, just talking about, I think it was Iron Sights.
Yeah, that makes sense. I feel like that's one I would go to. it was maybe the first or second time I really like delved into his channel. I was like, what is this? It wasn't
45 minutes of Cyclone Fence. Exactly. Best right. trailer was Captain Love. All right. Someone send me a link to Captain Love. And we'll get that up there. I want to make this show sort of more chat interactive and going with that. $5 from Unhinged Entertainment, just sending more than Eddie so I can out super chat him, even if it's only one time. And you still let me out. I left you, Jason. I'm so sorry. I left you out of my hello. I keep doing this. Well, you keep paying me, so maybe I'll continue to.
Right. Supply and demand. That's how it works.
$5. Thank you so much, Jason. And Blue's here. Hello, Blue.
Hello.
How are you going today?
I'm all right. I'm doing well. One problem is I Star Circuit. Okay, I saw your name. Now I know what we're doing tonight.
Awesome. Thank you.
Well, Joe is it's funny to have we don't have Joe Fulton, but we got another Joe. We've replaced Joe today.
It's the only annoyance I have with watching your show is I always like turn my head when you call Joe. it always messes with me.
So Joe has just recently he's been in the kind of back rooms asking about trailers and stuff, and I saw a lot of people were helping him out. I turned him on to a couple of people, and you know, lots of other people did as well. And he had that made, and I wanted to hear a little bit about the process of him getting that thing made. Who made your trailer? It was Ted, sure. Wasn't it?
Yeah, it was Ted Segarro. It's funny because me and him had a long chat about literally what we're probably going to talk about, just like what quality of trailers do we need in CG, and like the progression that we've had over the last couple of years. I've only been here for the last, maybe 8 months really seriously. So I don't even know how bad they maybe were in the far past, but he's a great editor.
Back in the day, it was a kind of, you don't really need it. And there's still a bunch of people who say the same thing. I mean, I don't think the trailers are going to sell anyone on a book, but it does round out the whole thing, and it adds a sense of professionalism. And I don't think people have taken it to where it can really go. I envision in the future, they're more like movie trailers where you're seeing some more of the story and less like,
by my book.
Less like what Greg is talking about here. The standard is a 30-second elevator pitch, show some pages and art. The ideal is a cinematic-style trailer. Exactly. So, sort of like, hi, I'm Michael. I've got a book that's coming out in Indiegogo. Right. It's got, this and that action. It's the best thing you're ever going to read. Back it today. And then, showing some pitches. I think, I hope we, move away a little bit from that and get to, say, more like, well, what Ted is doing
for sure.
Narwhal as well. Narwhal does animated trailers, and it's like trying to give you a bit of a sense of the story. It may not be, obviously you're not buying a cartoon, but you know, you get, you know, give you a sense of the story like a trailer should. Commissary Drew says, I loathe trailers where it's just pages and music. I think they're the ones that are kind of, yeah, going to go by the way of the dodo.
Right. I think Ted has what we really need is what Ted's doing. And I think that's, I don't want to call what we did with my trailer some sort of benchmark, but I think it is like a baseline. Like you can go better than what I've done and what we've done, but I think it's like cinematic enough. I think it does its job.
Leroy sent me $5 to say F you, Bancroft. Thank you, Leroy. Much appreciated, my friend. Zero Depressive sends 25 Rons. I don't know who Ron is, but thank you nonetheless, Zero Depressive. That's very generous. 300 had the best trailer. The movie? I think we're talking mostly about crowdfunding campaign trailers, but yes, that was a good trailer and a good movie.
Mm-hmm.
Dojo Kun for $5. Thank you so much. Another great trailer maker is Red Gaze. Yeah, I invited Red Gaze on, but so late, like literally 10 minutes ago. I think he's asleep because he's going to work.
Oh man.
Because I mean, I was sort of thinking more, you know, like, you know, we can talk about what you wanted from your trailer after mm-hmm. we're gonna premiere it in a little while. We can select like what, you know, what did you want from it? And right. Oh, hey, hang on. People are saying Bancroft, play the trailer. All right, maybe I will.
I mean, how many people we have in the room right now? 42.
Well, let's just quickly play a couple of the ones that people have said in the chat, and I agree are all good ones. Let's start with Black Flag, because this is a great one. Black Flag sharing audio. So the comment on that was it's fast, quick, gives you the you know, the sense of what kind of story you're gonna get. And yeah, let's just play it. Stop talking about it. It's not that fast. It's a minute 30.
I created Black Flag back in 1994. It was pure escapism. I want to draw guys with big guns. I want to draw anime babes, wizards, aliens. Cool, put them all in one book. Now allow me to reintroduce myself. Black Flag is literally wish fulfillment. High energy, high octane, 90s style action, relentless, doesn't ask for forgiveness, high bullet count. There hasn't been that in comics in the same way that I'm going to provide it. Sniper decided that he was going to go back into doing what he does best. He went and he took all of his gear, which had this shield on it with his flag, and he blacked out all the flags. He had no allegiance to anybody but himself. Then never sitting around talking in Black Flag issue 1. Ragtag, they're it. Here to save our world, all of them, mystical, magical. And we are going to see so many bullets, so much action. This thing is certain to blow people's minds. That's basically what Black Flag is all about. Let's go.
All right, so I haven't seen that in a while. That's kind of like a mix between what I was saying we're kind of moving away from, where it's like, hello, I'm this, that, and that, and this is what I'm doing. But then it also added in what the story is also going to be about.
Yeah, maybe, I feel like that's a good bridge, you know, between old and new. Almost.
It's a bit long, though. I feel like a minute 30 is probably a bit long. I remember my trailer is about that long, too, and I think it's too long. Eric says this trailer loses points for having rap. Leroy points out that the audio, yeah, the voice audio wasn't that great either. But it gave a good sense. It gave a good sense you know, what kind of story it's going to be. Here's another one I like. I don't know if I can play the whole thing because I think it is quite long. But this is a sort of a different take where he's kind of trying to sell on more of the, well, I'd say the charisma of the creator. And that's another one that was pointed out earlier, Captain Love. Have you heard this one, Joe?
I have. He was on maybe Publishing Pete's open mic, I think, at one point. I saw it there.
And again, he goes with the music. Here we go.
Greetings. My name is Spade.
Oh, this is a different one. I thought this is the singing one. Hold on, maybe he gets into it. I know, but this is doing the same thing they did before. I was thinking about the singing one. Change the course of the solar system. Well, that was a fail. What's the other one? Maybe someone can give me a link to the other one, or maybe it's somewhere else. Oh, promo video. Here we go.
Captain Love is a space trucker and former war hero. Accompanied by a rogue artificial intelligence named Spade, he reluctantly finds himself on adventures that could affect the course of the solar system. Captain Love, the hero of the cleansing, is 72 beautiful full-color pages and the...
People were talking about Red. Why is Red not here? Look, I invite him. Yes, I invite him too late. I'm sorry. Yeah, I was thinking of the one where he sings. Where's the one where he sings? I love that thing.
I'm pretty sure I've seen them all. I don't know where that one is.
I just want to give people a taste of... No, it's not this one. Massive fail. No, I don't know where he is, but he sings a song. It's very funny.
It definitely had like a fun nature to it.
Yeah, because that's what the thing. It's like kind of a sexy, fun romp comic, and he's doing his thing. I thought that was really clever. But it looks like he's done a bunch of different trailers now, and he's included one from Red there. Inexcusable, says Power Rider. It is. I'm terribly sorry. I'm terribly sorry. Apparently, Red has a day job. He has to work. $9.99 from Black Rose Comics. Play the Lucent trailer.
Yeah, actually, it's a good trailer. I like both of the Orc trailers. The Accolades trailer too.
Thank you. I'm ruining this stream. 20 minutes in, and Bancroft is turning in a shit show already. Did you expect anything different? All right. I'll play my actual trailer. Only because Bros paid me to, though. Only because I get paid. I mean, I can't say no to him at this point. Here we go. This is the real trailer, not the propaganda one.
Right.
When dreams and reality collide, a life is turned upside down. Into a conflict where ancient shadows fight secret wars.
Thank you, Obar Ideas. Yes. I went with more of a kind of feeling, and as Leroy pointed out, I didn't actually say anything about what the book is. The whole thing is about what the book is about, Leroy. I'm sorry if I made it a bit vague, but I stole the music from Inception. It is pretty Nolan-esque. I will give you that. The dings and the booms and the...
Who did the voiceover for that one?
That was me.
Oh, really?
And I just kind of put like a deepening thing on it, and then a guy called Ascension Cinema went over the top of it and sort of spruced it up a bit and added in reverbs and all this sort of stuff. But I think it did pretty well. It did pretty well. It wasn't the one, I apologize, that you wanted, Black Rose, but it was a Lucent trailer. You did ask, play the Lucent trailer.
And it was so fast that it's not like I got up, you know, the moment you hit play, went and peed, mixed a drink, nothing like that. No,
really. It was way too long. Way too long. My God. Yeah. I know. What can I say? Hey, I wasn't going to play it. They paid me to play it. Reverb and cowbells, says Vanessa. But look, it must have worked on some people. It worked on Dean. Fantastic. And because we don't have Red here, Blue has been very kind and passed me the trailer for his new Sunsworn 2 trailer. So this is an example of what Red is up to at the moment. And for anyone who doesn't know, Red Gaze, a creator, he's out there. He's an option for anyone who wants to get a trailer made. He will do them for you. We've already seen one of them already, and he's got a great voice. So yeah, let's get into it. He likes them epic.
Mm-hmm. After centuries of peace, the Astral Union is faced with a galaxy-wide threat from a foe long forgotten. As the Union spirals into chaos, it falls to Aster Sunsworn and his companions to save what remains of a galaxy on the edge of annihilation. Sunsworn is a full-length novel that will reignite the fire of the space fantasy genre. Over 300 pages of a galactic adventure, with a visual companion featuring some of the best artists in Comicscape that will introduce you to the Sunsworn universe. Be a part of the next great space fantasy saga. Back Sunsworn today.
There you go. So that's sort of a taste of the kinds of trailers that Red does. So he'll do pretty cool, I guess it's like a slideshow with a bit of animation, and then importantly, you'll get a voiceover. Do you have a voiceover on your one, Joe?
I do.
There you go. Fantastic. I think I really think a voiceover is, I wouldn't say it's essential, but it's highly recommended. There's one trailer in particular that doesn't have a voiceover, but my goodness, does it make up for it in other ways. And it's this one right here, which has been pointed out about 20 times so far. And it's, this, of course, the Starblaze trailer, probably the best trailer that we've seen from any CG campaign, let alone any normal crowdfunding campaign. Kyle just, animated this, and I don't think he animates. He just, I'm just going to do this because why not? Just amazing, absolutely stunning. Let's just play it. I mean, stop talking about it and play it. And I can't play because I didn't put the audio on.
Yeah, this one, it's incredible. It makes me want to put animation in mine.
Yeah, but can you, this is the thing. There's no real option to get this done. This is just sort of an anomaly that we can all just look at and say,
right.
Because, can you imagine how much this would cost to pay someone to do it? Liam says, if you play the Xenotype, should I play the Taupe? I would love that one. If you could send me the link to that, Liam, because that is a great trailer. I love Planet Tobol's trailers. Maybe send me the link on Twitter. All right, here we go. Audio is on. Here we go. Soak it up. Just look at this.
Yeah, it looks like it aired on HBO already.
It does, doesn't it? I think, as someone who's done a bit of animation, you look at it and you say, okay, so this is something where he could have just actually animated the thing, moved it and scaled it. But there's so many bits in that where, mm-hmm. No, he's properly animating characters. They're moving. Yeah. And it's fantastic. I would watch that movie in a heartbeat.
Yeah, it's not motion comic animation.
No, right, no, right. It's exactly right, Billy. It's the gold standard. It's so good. Did Hockey, is that the first time you've ever seen that trailer? It looks like an anime opening. And yeah, you know, that's kind of like the pinnacle, I think, of it's quick, 40 seconds long. Even though you don't hear about the story, you don't need to, you see the story. And you know, yeah, so I think that's sort of like the gold standard that everybody
I like
it to go for, but I don't know what's gonna happen.
I was gonna say I like the audio, but it could be Ryan, what's up? But I think the audio could be one level above to be super gold standard. I think it would be the audio that would be the upgrade, not the animation. Oh,
like get it a bit more epic.
Yeah, just master it better. I think the production, it could be the speakers that I'm hearing it right now, but I think it could be just the audio that's needing a better mastering, maybe.
Yeah, I think we're hearing it in a weird, distant audio, like it's not present enough. It's almost like, and I know it's not literally this because Mike doesn't have speakers on, it's almost like it's coming through speakers back into a microphone. Because I remember the audio on that originally. That's not what it sounded like just now.
Right. Now I'm afraid for my
computer. Oh, maybe. Yeah, maybe it is that. I don't know. Oh, Matt. I'm sure he worked that out. I'm sure he had that.
Actually, he does hear bass. It has to be loud bass, but he does hear bass. And he had somebody work out for him where the beats were. And he described what kind of music he wanted to her. And she worked out where the beats were and just kind of mapped it for him. And so he just edited his animation to that. So it was a good move.
That is cool.
Hold on a sec.
I feel like a documentary should be running around that. That's pretty cool.
I have got, this is the trailer by Matt Fitzgerald, Planet Tobor. He does fantastic trailers. This guy makes video games, and he made a trailer for his video game, and it's fantastic. And I'm going to share it right now. So this is the trailer for Xenotype made by Planet Tobor.
Xenotype is a dark science fiction series that combines the best of Western storytelling with shonen battle manga. This genre-redefining epic introduces the high-flying transformation hero Esper and showcases his first contact with the enigmatic horrors of the Black Diamond Conspiracy. If you're a fan of Akira, Attack on Titan, Biobooster Armageddon, or Tokyo Ghoul, Xenotype is going to blow your mind! Featuring the story and powerful prose of Liam Gray, the vivid, brilliant colors of Spartan Scotsman, and the blistering, wrist-breaking artwork of multi-award-winning mangaka Odysseus Theodoratos. Don't miss out. Get Xenotype! Evolve. Or die. Only on Indiegogo.
So that was Matt Tobor doing that.
That was Matt Tobor. Yeah, doing the voiceover. I love his voiceover. Red, thank you so much for coming.
What up? No problem, man. I saw the harassment you were receiving from the chat, and I just couldn't. Sorry. For this is the one time I'm going to stand up for Michael Bancroft.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank Vinny. Vinny was the one who was like, I can't believe he's doing a show and he doesn't have Red coming on. I mean, what the hell? They're talking about trailers.
Yeah, I'm glad you're here as well.
Ryan Cardinal. For $5, say, yo, Bancroft, if you show the trailer for Chaos, A Story of Blood and Stone Issue 1, that would be dope. Has anyone got the link for that, considering he's a paying customer, $5?
I'll work on it. Hey, Red, since you're here, I got questions because we've talked about voiceovers and being more cinematic and things like that. Yes. So I've loaded up a few links that I haven't even dropped to Mike yet. I'm going to look for that Chaos one, I think it was, K-A-Y-S. And so I want to know, what kind of microphone are you using? Is it a dynamic or a electret type? And how much distance do you put between your mouth and that microphone?
I use a standard Blue Yeti. I put about 6 inches to a foot between my mouth and the microphone, depending.
Okay.
I don't know. It's a kind of a heated debate, isn't it, between voiceover versus non-voiceover. I think it just depends on your style. Like when people are asking me for trailers, I just kind of ask them what they want, you know? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, if you were to do one that is more like a movie trailer that is more kind of showing the story and stuff, I guess you don't really need a voiceover. You could even, although you could get into like voice acting and have characters actually saying lines from the comic and stuff like that. I've thought about that, but it's, you know, it can start getting a bit expensive when you start getting into all that.
Yeah, you definitely could. And I've seen people do that too. I don't know. Honestly, it all depends. Like, I mean, the chat are really the best people to ask because, you know, people, the customers, they know what they like to see. They know what they want. But yeah, I've had some good success with voiceovers. I've had some good success with nothing, you know, just music and imagery. And also sometimes to make up for a lack of voiceover, maybe throw in a little bit of text here and there just to kind of fill people in as they're going along.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. Now, well, here's another trailer that you did read. I'm going to play it quickly. One of your most recent ones. Thank you, Leroy.
Are we missing Mo or something? Is Leroy filling in Mo duty?
He must be. He must be.
I miss Mo.
Yeah. Where's Mo today? You got to be important to remember to not to cut out that last bit that says only on Indiegogo, as has happened very recently to poor Vinny. Although they did sort that all out.
That's for sure.
Like I posted you two links so far in the private chat. The first one I think is a good example of mixing what Red Gaze was just talking about with text and voiceover.
All right.
So I know I'm interrupting something, but when we get there.
Yeah, no, that's a good one. That's a good one.
A virus is released to the population. It kills
the dulcet tones of Clayton Barton. It's
called the Red Death. A new city is born amongst the chaos, free from the disease, but only for the privileged. Hope emerges as a scientist is on the verge of a cure, but before she can finish it, she disappears.
Rob, was this Ted Zagaro? I believe this is Ted Zagaro.
Who are you?
In order to save her, her husband is forced down a path he might not come back from.
Riker, help me.
But you'd do anything to save the ones you love, wouldn't you? Anything?
That, I think, is my favorite kind of trailer. One that gives you a bit of a taste of the story. As much as I do love other ones, like your ones are like so like epic and like punching at me, Red. and they're great. I want to try and get towards that sort of somewhat replicating a a cinema trailer.
Replicator.
Yeah. Well, not replicating.
I noticed they had elements of voiceover with text on the screen, but not overbearing on either of those. You had character voiceover cinematically that way, and then the music bed was a mixture of either a touch of music here and then sound effect there, and so it really did a lot of what Red Gaze does, but in taking all the pieces and using a little of each rather than blasting you with everything.
You're right.
I'm trying to get you with all the techniques.
I think it's weird because cinema, like in movies, the whole voiceover thing kind of went outdated. Like you don't see any movies that are like
in the world.
Yeah, you don't have that anymore. But that kind of fits comics a little bit because it's just it bridges the gap, I think.
I think you're right, and that's interesting. You mentioned that too, because you don't really hear that anymore. You don't hear the iconic cinema voices for every trailer anymore.
Right.
Did you have an idea for what you wanted for your trailer, Joe?
I want to like see it play and get the reaction first, because I if I say it, I think you're going to see it immediately and it might draw you from what it is. But I did have a vision for it. I wanted to tell a story within the trailer, and yep. Ted was really cool about finding that in between where I'm kind of dry. I'm more like you. I think like I was trying to go too dry with it, and he just made it this punchy, epic balance that you get a little bit of both.
Well, I remember when I played my trailer for John Mayall, and he was like, it feels a bit like low energy, but I didn't want it to be super punchy because I don't want people to think that that was the kind of book they were getting, that it would be this nonstop action-packed, fast-paced story. So I didn't want that in the trailer either. Right. So I think, different kinds of stories, different kinds of things. The Mr. Mo Biggs is here in the house. Hello, mate. Hello, Mo.
Hello, Mo.
He finally made it. There's one other trailer that I wanted to play before getting to yours, Joe, which was brought up by someone else as an example of a trailer with voice acting in it, and it's voice acting by another guy with another popular voice. Where is it? Oh, I've got it in the friggin' wrong. Another fail. Another day. Another fail. It's all right.
Yeah, I think this trailer
in the wrong browser. Mm-hmm.
I think this trailer you're about to show is one that is a highlight for voiceover.
That really takes me back, Michael. Another day, another day.
Do you know what?
Blue? I heard that on every birthday. But anyway, what were you saying?
Do you know what we did the other day? We went back and watched the very first stream I ever did. Well, I mean, the first 10 minutes of it or so. And you were there, and Joe King was there, and a bunch of people were there. And my goodness, if you think this is bad, everyone go and check that out, because oh my god. It's worth watching, actually. All right, so yeah, apparently this has Von Klaus doing voice acting in it. So let's take a listen. I've got the audio going. Yep.
We've received a transmission from the planet Bandrill. Shall we give it a listen?
I'm calling you because my planet is sick. And not the monarchy. Not the Royal Guard, not a single person on this spinning rock seems to care. It started gradually. First, it got into our heads. By the time I realized something was wrong, by the time I woke up, we were already here. Things look perfect at first glance. But that's how the aliens work. That's how the invasion starts. A slow boil. I'm calling you because I can't trust anyone here. You're off planet. You're a professional. And I'm afraid. We might already be dead.
Flynn? How shall I respond?
It's a job. Let's suit up.
I've never seen that.
Oh,
you know, I've never seen that either, and I backed that book.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I just backed it. I was that wasn't up on the campaign on day one because I'm pretty sure I'm a day one backer, or maybe I just didn't watch it.
You didn't click it. Yeah, it was just that good. The art.
So I'm hearing all the different epic music. Red, did you compose or get any non not DRM? You know what I'm asking. Non paid for music for the trailer you made for Vinny, or what's going on with that?
Yeah, all the ones I search out copyright free. I don't compose anything yet. That's actually something I'm thinking about delving into. But just gradually upping the game. So I'm not at that stage yet. But always try to search for non-copyright. The problem with that is a lot of times things are advertised as non-copyright, and then you play them on a stream and the stream gets hit.
You find out later.
Right.
Ryan Cardinal said that one is dope. Everyone making these trailers shouldn't sleep on them. It adds the total of what your IP is. I really agree on that. And Greg says this trailer hits on the beats. Remember what I said earlier about beats? It absolutely did. That was really good. I was really, you know, engrossed, and I'm already a backer. So I'm sure it's helped him along. Jimmy says some campaigns have funds to raise for a creative team, may not have enough art for an animated trailer. Yeah, and then there's animated, and then there's, I think that a lot of them are just sort of like fancy slideshows. You know, like you can do that in After Effects and get cool transitions. That's what I did. Mine's a fancy slideshow with an After Effects transition.
Yeah, right. Apple called it the Ken Burns effect.
There you go.
He brings up a good point, though, because my art is all already done. So any book that is in that position, you have so much more available art to throw into the trailer up front, you know?
You do. And we are at the 40-minute mark. So it's time.
All right.
we haven't hit that $10 you paid for yet.
Oh, what $10?
Not you paid for, excuse me. Ryan Cardinal paid for.
What did Ryan Cardinal pay for?
His trailer.
He did. I apologize. I've even got it pulled up. So.
I thought I was the one that just got out of bed, Mike.
It's hot in here. It's hot in the shed. It's summer. Crazy.
And
I'm actually not that good at multitasking. You might not have noticed. Actually, I'm going to open up a beer. And you know what? I had a beer the other day, and these are Twist Tops. And I mean, I've been neglecting poor Skip by opening these with my hands, and not using his wrench. So I just wanted to point that out again in case he's still watching. There we go. It's not that easy to open a Twist Top with a thingo. Sad Blue needs to babysit back. I'm slacking. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. Okay, this is the Chaos Indiegogo trailer. I'm going to share screen. I'm going to share audio. Thank you again, Ryan Cardinal, for the $10 super chat. And let's check out what he's got on offer for us. Better animation. There you go. That's Chaos, the story of blood and stone. Thanks again for the super chat. I do agree with Leroy, especially if you're not going to have any voiceover, you got to hold people's attention. I think you could probably cut that thing down to under a minute at least.
Also, when I was doing production, people figured out I was a musician really fast, and I wondered how they knew. It's because I would accidentally cut things to the music and not realize I was doing it, you know, between video and audio and even changing. We had to do one background fill for a voiceover for the DJs, and it was just cutting between multiple song intros that they could do a station ID over. And somebody noticed that it was every song intro, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the next beat was a new song. And that's how I got outed as a musician when I was working in college radio. But yeah, it's always better to try and edit where the visuals there were meaningful in that trailer we just saw, where I appreciated seeing several elements that were in it, but it had the music really had nothing to do with it. They didn't go together.
Yeah, I think the first like 10 seconds was bomb. And then
the last bit as well was good. You could probably just stitch those two together and get something more impactful. It does, you know, you don't need to know all the stuff. You can put that stuff on the campaign page. I mean, I learned that as well. I think my original teaser trailer was about 4 minutes long or something like that. All right, we have waited. We've dilly-dallied far too long. Let me hide this. Joe, it is your moment of truth. So, yes, this is the trailer for Star Circuit by our good friend here, Joe Catapano. I am pronouncing that right, am I?
That is right. I think everybody hesitates just a second. Ethan, whenever he does my super chats, he'll pause. But everybody gets it, I think. Joe Catapano.
Excellent, excellent. And yeah, I'm very excited to see this. Happy to see that it's 57 seconds long, and it is by Ted Zagara, who we were familiar with. Ted, I think, did the another trailer I love is the Sovereign Wolf.
Yeah, Eddie's, man. So good.
Yeah, it's a fantastic one. So I've got high hopes for this. I have not seen it. I'll take it back to the start, and here we go. World premiere.
Welcome to the future. A place where you can find anything you desire. If the burner gangs don't find you first. Where the fastest racers are artificial. And if you're human, you don't stand a chance. Star Circuit.
Fantastic. sorry, I'm just reading Mo Big's comment there. It's the Inner World guy, and Stan Lee had a love child and narrated this. So we were just you were just talking about the you know, that narration.
Yeah,
you know, it does actually fit there with that, and that's kind of like a mix between what we're saying, like doing that cinematic sort of showing the story, and
so that's what I told them in the beginning. I gave them the beats, as I forget who said it, but I gave them the beats, Ted, and Ted was like, we can do these beats. Let me just mix a lot of these images together and we'll work from there. And we got the voiceover done. But yeah, I didn't know how it was going to work, but my vision was like those old school Toonami commercials that had that kind of Optimus Prime voice, you know, going with it.
Optimus, so Optimus Prime is a love child of the trailer guy and Stan Lee.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What do you reckon, Red?
Oh no, that was good. I liked it. I thought it fit very well with the voiceover on top, especially with the Inner World guy vibe to it. Yeah, that was good, man. I liked it.
Who did your voicing for that?
Just some dude on Fiverr, but you know, we talked about it, me and Ted, and he was like, it's probably a good shot. Just review a few different people on Fiverr and find somebody that has got a decent rate for the rights, you know? So,
okay.
Yeah. By the way, that was a good length too. I think a lot of people shoot a little too far. I think personally, I think 30 seconds is too short. Over a minute and 30 is too long.
Yeah.
That's just my personal preference.
I think I'm planning on doing some teaser trailers in the build up to the next one and doing some, you know, between, I'm thinking, you know, 20 or 30 seconds or so, just like teasers. Although, you know, maybe you do the minute long trailer and then eventually you put out the 30 second one later as like, as people are familiar with it. Like my one now, I don't want to play it anymore because it's so long. You know, so it's like, it kind of really does break. And you notice in the chat, as soon as you start playing something that's longer than a minute, people start
toning out. Yeah.
They start tuning out and, you know, giving crap to each other and essentially saying it's too long. I know there's, look guys, there's a million trailers we missed. I've seen you in the chat. Like, I can't believe you haven't played this. I can't believe you haven't played that. I get it. There's so many great trailers. I guess the point of the show is to sort of like, you know, talk about, man, how far these things have gone since when they started. And it was, well, you know, like a guy sitting on his balcony to that we just saw. And I think everyone really, really dig that. But Joe's here. We've got him here. We've got at least 10 minutes left. We might go a little bit over because we did linger.
What I like about what you did there with that, I like what you did with your trailer there. Okay, good. We got that up. I'll pull the link for you, Mike, because it's clear. Something that came up with the trailer Vaughn did, a mistake all of us make early in audio is, his alien voice there has a lot of effect on it, and it's just teetering on the edge. I would say it doesn't cross the line, but it's really close to where the effect overtakes what we're supposed to hear and understand. And so at the wrong volume on that Vaughn voiceover we heard, you might not make out what he's saying at all. And instead, in your trailer, we have somebody who's doing a voice, but it doesn't ruin what's being said. It might even hold your attention because it's so off. And that's a trick you're supposed to use when you're doing announcing.
And here's
the attention.
And here's another thing that Jason's pointing out, that it's not so much the duration, it's the pacing. If the elements of the trailers, it's the elements of the trailers that make him switch off, not the time. So if you don't have the right beats, you know, if you're not building to something.
Yeah, he's absolutely right.
The music too. I didn't want to bring it up before, but because Ted did the music on mine as well, and he, for a while, he didn't have a progression. Like it was the same beat, the same tone, and it didn't have a progression in the melody. So I had him switch that up, and the minute we did that, we're missing a climax, and so we had to edit that in. But it was cool to see.
Don't get me wrong, Ryan Cardinal. I love it as much as the Lex guy. I mean, yeah, it is a classic. You're right. It was a moment in time, and I wouldn't have it any other way. You know, we're not all, it's becoming very competitive out there, and having something that people want to play on their streams and share. You know, you could, if you get a cool trailer that you know, people want to watch it, you put that on Twitter or Facebook or wherever, and then you start getting the views and potentially, you know, try and get this thing to go a little bit viral. I mean, that's the goal. Mm-hmm. That's the goal of these things. Sure. It's not so much you get to the page and then, okay, am I going to back? Well, I'll watch the trailer to see if I'm going to back. It's not really about that, although, you know, I think it does complete the page. I whenever I see a campaign that doesn't have a trailer, I notice it.
Yeah,
but you can do the reverse too, though. Like, you can be looking over the page and be like, this looks pretty cool, and then scroll up to the trailer and, like, it's some dude in his underwear, and you're like, okay, never mind.
Yeah, right. Speaking of things right, going viral, though, it is on my YouTube channel right now. Anybody wants to watch it again, it's up on my YouTube channel. It's just my name.
Joe Catapano. Fantastic. Yeah. Maybe someone can get a link for that. All right. So we'll tell us a little bit about this book, man. It looks great. I see exactly what you're trying to do here. I think you're nailing it. Let us know. And I love what, actually, before you do that, mm-hmm. I like how you said in the trailer, if you're not, you know, whoever's driving them, I don't know if they're robots, cyborgs, mm-hmm. whatever. If you're a human, you don't stand a chance in this race.
Right.
And I, you know, we know that setup. I love that. That's great. That's like a great hook into the story. So anyway, you can probably tell it.
Sure. It took a long time to find those words specifically for the trailer because I came up with so many different little small elevator pitches. But the best one I've got is that in the future, culture revolves around this high-speed motorcycle league where androids have dominated the competition. In fact, humans can't even qualify. They just don't have the reaction time, and it's to the point where it's almost suicide to even attempt like pro racing. So this is where the main character comes in. He's just an arrogant street racer. And we follow this guy to this point where he meets an old school racer, one that raced before the androids, and he kind of like syncs with him. And through that, he starts this journey of not only becoming better at racing, but becoming better as a person and saving his family and saving society and all at the same time. So much going on, but this is the first chapter that starts it all. And you'll get to see this giant 10-page motorcycle race that is the big feature of the first book.
That's a real sci-fi because a thing that's actually happening right now in the world with certain things where it's like if they can sort of unlock the whatever the algorithm and you know they can design a AI to do something and you know, as a human you know you don't stand a chance and this is something that you know like we're facing as a you know as a civilization
for sure with with any kind of quantum computer you're just going to not even be in the realm and that's what I wanted it to seem like you're not even in the realm of trying. And so it gives this giant, the second act of the story is just this giant like learning curve. And that's going to be really fun to do.
Tell us, is this your main character here with the,
that's the main character, Atlas with a Y because I'm a fan of Sid Mead and he spells it with a Y. But, so Atlas is the asshole street racer. And he's got a family that's kind of torn apart by a tragedy early on. And so it's kind of like him dealing with craziness with his family and him like not really being a full person. And at the same time, having to deal with like gangs trying to kill him and just living this crazy street racer life until he actually starts pro racing.
Greg asks, does it have elements for people who aren't into racing?
Yeah, it was so weird early on when I started pitching this book. Anytime I mentioned racing, someone would say, don't mention racing. No one knows. No one cares about racing. It's really not about the racing. That's why I mentioned so much about the family and so much about like him developing and like gangs and the sci-fi stuff because the race, I like racing, but not to the point where I'm going to be talking about, angles and hitting the apex and, you know, stuff that racers would really care about. But yeah, anybody who just likes adrenaline filled books will like this.
So the racing is really a MacGuffin.
I wouldn't call it a MacGuffin. It is it's a plot device.
It's a setting.
Oh, setting. Right. Okay.
Right. Yeah. I picked cyberpunk in general because I could have picked something else totally to fit the theme. And the theme is how do humans cope when they're becoming obsolete? So the only way to do that is to put them in a position where they are. And cyberpunk made sense.
Yeah, man. I know. I just really like it. I like, you know, well, first off, art sells me on books. You know, how would you really describe your style? Because it's not something that I'm very familiar with. It's sort of...
I don't even really know how to describe it. And I do my best by just saying all my influences from American comics that are not super old school, even though I like Jim Lee and the old school guys, you know, but I like Rockford a lot. And I like guys that have intricate pencil work and a lot of the guys like Joe Mad as well. So something between that
and animation style, says Phil. I think I think you're kind of just doing your own thing. I wouldn't even put anyone's name or style on. I'm just, it looks like to me you're kind of doing your own thing. The lines are simple, but there's a lot of them and they're the end result is actually quite complicated, but then you're using this cel-shaded coloring And yeah, I mean, I dig it. And then, you know, you've got the kind of cyberpunk influences with the color palettes and everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got a little bit of a little bit of a reveal. I can share something real quickly that will give you a little bit of a taste of, because recently I realized I wanted to have, I got so much extra art that I wanted to have a concept art book. And I'm calling it Layouts and Design. So I got the cover for that, which kind of blends the cover with, with the real cover, you know, so it'd be cool. The pencils. So you can kind of see how much pencil work I do and then throw, the colors on top in Photoshop or actually Clip Studio now.
Yeah. Right. Is that going to be like a supplemental or something to the
It'll be the same size. My book is 32 pages. And this will be another 32 page supplemental. And we'll probably have a bundle where you get that plus the trading card and a few other little things combined as the feature. I do have other like small and big things. I might actually have a 3D model of the bike, which we call the burner, because it burns data instead of fuel. But
hang on. How does that work?
Okay, so it's interesting because I thought about how Tesla was doing their brakes and where the brakes charged the battery. And I thought if there were some sort of gate that data passed through when it transfers from device to device, if there was a gate that captured the friction that binary data would create, it could charge something. And that's how everything works in my universe. Everything's working in this renewable way where data is the catalyst for energy.
Mm. So and for anyone who feels left out, what do they call them? The other hybrids, the horrible ones from Toyota, they do that too.
Leaf? No.
Prius. Prius. The Prius, yes.
That's another one of my favorite South Park episodes. Well, the Prius episode where everyone's smelling their own farts.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
that. All right. Yeah. So, you can sign up to Star Circuit. Man, I'm totally going to have you back. When this thing goes live, when's it
launching February 16th, so we're under a month.
Oh, that's close.
It's really close. Yeah, I'm super psyched. I have pretty much everything together, the logistics. Now that the trailer's out there, I'll be pushing and trying to schedule. So I'll be in touch about trying to get on your stream because you got a
for sure.
You got a sexy show.
From the moment I saw this, I really dug it. Is that like a tent something? Is there like a really it's a society where there's really huge inequity between the
right. It's there, but it's weird because there's UBI where it's everyone is getting some sort of basic living standards.
Yeah.
But since there's no need to work because of Androids taking all the labor out of the market, everyone just do whatever they want. So there's the slums where people are just having fun, doing whatever they want. Gangs just run amok because there's no really need to worry about it. The Androids cover most of the death and the crime because like there's so many sensors that you just can't do that many bad things in a row where a danger zone would arise.
So this is like, this is real sci-fi. This is science fiction. Like this is, you know, storytelling with a theme and a message that is applicable to the real world. I'm really digging this.
Yeah. I had a goal to get my stuff out before Cyberpunk 2077 and thank God it flopped. So, what can you do?
Does it have that 1970s sci-fi like downer twist ending where everything's hopeless and already destroyed or, you know?
I can't give that away, but it is in my mind and has been, though I did rewrite this story several times at 4 a.m. So
we've all done that. Wake up, you're like, ah,
yeah.
Bancroft is like this. So this is how you write a book.
Rob.
And Red, man, thank you so much for coming in. I feel absolutely obliged to. Now we did actually play your trailer before, Red, before you jumped on. I don't know if you saw that.
Oh, I did actually. That was the vintage stuff.
Oh, that's why. Oh, I've got the wrong one up here. I just typed in. You know what I did? I typed in Sunswan, and okay, I will. I would, because you have graced us with your presence and you know you're a working man.
Leroy's
already giving us the judgment here. 2 out of 10, terrible. Somewhere Mark Poulton is fine. Mark had a great time and he thanked me personally. So take that. Let me actually, the fact that
Red delivered my book yesterday. Thank you, Red. We'll play.
You're welcome. Thank you.
You got Red's book. Right. I showed the old stuff. Let me show the new stuff. I don't want it to be like I like your old stuff better than your new stuff. This is Sunsworn Wings of Vengeance. What was the original one called? Edge of Annihilation.
Yeah, the novel is Edge of Annihilation. I'm going to be doing some comic campaigns in between the novel campaign, so this is what's coming next. It's actually going to end up being 2 books on one campaign, so that should be fun.
I like Red when he's like, you wake me up for this? Are you serious?
Yeah, to be fair, I was half asleep watching your stream, and I saw all the comments you were getting. I was like, oh, poor Ben.
People wanted the gaze, and the gaze delivers. All right, I'm going to play this trailer. Only on Indiegogo.
I think it's more important than ever that we include that in all trailers at this point.
Right. Although Ryan Wilson finds it problematic. There's no women of color, no LGBTQ leads. Triggered. Triggered. Thank you so much, Red, for jumping in. That's awesome. Everyone go check out Red's Indiegogos and subscribe to Red Gay's channel.
Please and thank you.
What was that? Sorry?
I said please and thank you.
Man, this beer, this VB, I'm not used to it. I'm getting there. I'm just going to say that. I'm finding it hard to string my words together. So
we can start trying to take advantage already.
Is it the heat? Is it the heat in this damn shed? There's something going on here. It's,
well, whatever it is,
you're hard to focus.
In 5 minutes, you'll be back on your job you get paid for. So who cares?
That's true. Although it's the last hour, so it's all right. Joe, thank you so much for coming on, man. We'll definitely get you back for the launch of your book. Congrats on the trailer.
Thank you.
And a big applause to Mr. Ted Zagaro, because I think he really knocked it out of the park with that. I hadn't seen it till then.
He definitely deserves it. Yeah.
Purely on the... the trust that Ted would come through, and he absolutely did. People are saying play more trailers. We will make it stop. We're well past the hour now. Everyone go sign up to Star Circuit. Joe, you mentioned you've got a YouTube channel.
I do. It's Joe Catapano on YouTube. Catapano Art on Twitter.
Easy peasy. Yep. I even shilled the Lucent tonight. Thank you, Bros, Black Rose, for making me play my trailer, even though it wasn't the trailer you asked for. I can't put everyone through that every night. I mean, that's just cruel and unusual punishment. But yeah, the campaign's going well. Everyone, if there's anyone here who isn't subscribed to the channel, because I know that there's a good 30 or 40% of you who watch who aren't subscribed. Make sure you subscribe. I don't know why you wouldn't. Leroy says you did a good job, Joe.
Thanks, Leroy.
He's not saying that to anyone else. Eddie says, later, guys. Hello, Eddie Winkler. A big fan of Mr. Eddie Winkler.
Oh, yeah.
And Ryan Wilson says, is Lucient finished yet? It's this close. I'm doing the finishing touches, the fixes, making it as good as I possibly can for all you wonderful backers out there. All right. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Red. Thank you, Blue. And the chat. Hail to the chat. Best chat in all of CG. Sexiest chat in Comiskate. You can tell tonight I relied on you. I didn't have any other trailers loaded up. I thought, don't do that because the chat is going to have their own ideas. You came through. You gave me the suggestions. They were all brilliant. Yeah. And what day is today? Yes, we will have another show tomorrow. It's going to be a good one. All right, guys. We'll see you then. Bye.